Students, you have studied that plants grow in different climatic conditions. To cope up with the climate, they show adaptations. Hence now, you are familiar with many names of plants. Let us see pictures of some common plants around us like grass, vinca, hibiscus, mango, coconut, etc. Now, can you tell me some of their important features? All plants growing around us are fixed in soil. They do not change their place. Almost all plants possess green leaves. Hence, they produce food for themselves and for others. With the help of water and CO2, plants produce glucose in the presence of sunlight. Hence, they produce. In this process, food is formed and O2 is released. Plants which we normally see around us possess underground roots, aerial organs like stem, leaves, beautiful flowers and fruits. So, today let's study and know about plant organs. We will observe few plant specimens perform simple activities for this study. Also tell me about various parts of plants. So how do we identify plants? Plants are fixed in soil, produce food by photosynthesis. Plants possess roots, stems, leaves, flowers and fruits. Soak some pea, soya bean, gram seeds in water overnight. Then allow them to grow on moist tissue paper. After one day, you will find that a small tiny projection comes out from seed. This is the radical. Now allow the radical to grow further. You will realize that it is growing downwards. This radical forms roots of the plant. So when you place these seeds in soil, radical grows towards soil and give rise to roots. Remember, roots always grow towards soil where there is water. On the other hand, your germinating seeds produce an axis that has tiny green leaves in addition to the radical. This is called the plumule. A plumule grows upwards, that is away from soil, towards sunlight. This plumule gives rise to stem of the plant. What do you see when a seed sprout? A germinating seed produces radical and plumule. Radical formed grows towards soil and water. Roots are formed from radical. Plumule grows away from soil and in direction of light. Plumule gives rise to stem of plant. Roots further grow deep in soil as well as spread in all directions. What is the role of roots? Roots hold soil firmly, give support to the plant. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. Carefully uproot a small plant of grass or onion and a plant like vinca, tomato, brinjal, pea, etc. Take care that roots do not break while uprooting the plant. Wash the roots with water to remove soil particles attached to it. Now let us observe roots of vinca, tomato, brinjal, pea to understand their types. In the specimen of vinca, there is main root in the center called primary or tap root. This develops from the radical. Now you will also see that primary root bears smaller branches. These are called secondary roots. Sometimes even secondary roots produce branches. Together, all of them constitute the tap root system. Students, you will see that tap root is long and it grows very deep in soil. The portion of tap root near the soil is broad and thick while it becomes narrow at the other end. Secondary roots spread horizontally over a large area. Now let us study roots of grass or onion. In these plants, radical has a short life. Very soon, the radical develops into a bunch of small roots. This is called fibrous or adventitious roots system. Sometimes while working in the garden, have you uprooted unwanted plants or weeds? It is difficult to uproot old weeds. Yes, as their roots grow deep in soil. But uprooting grass-like plants is easier because their roots are superficial. This happens because tap root grows deep in soil where adventitious roots are superficial. So, can you guess the type of root system present in mango tree and sugarcane plant? Usually, tall trees have tap root and short plants possess adventitious roots. Types of root system: tap root system and adventitious roots system. Tap root system. Radical grows into a tap root. presence of primary and secondary roots. Taproot grows deep in soil. It is present in dicotyledonous plants like tomato, pea, mango, etc. Adventitious roots system. Radical is short-lived. Absence of primary and secondary roots. Bunch of roots are present. Adventitious roots are superficial. Present in monocotyledonous plants like grass, maize, sugarcane, etc. The two types of root systems can be easily studied. Allow sprouts of pea or bean to grow in soil for some days, then uproot the plant carefully to study taproot system. It is very easy to grow onion roots at home. Take a bulb of onion and scrape off its old dried roots. Remove dry papery leaves of the bulb. Place this bulb in a glass bottle filled with water. Take care of that disc like stem portion is in contact with water. Fresh adventitious roots grow in just 3 to 4 days. So far you have studied the structure, types and functions of roots. But besides normal functions, in some plants, roots have variety of roles to play. We will see some examples. Carrot, radish, beetroot, sweet potato, banyan tree. Can you believe that all these are roots? Yes, all these are roots which look quite different. In case of plants like carrot, radish, beetroot, sweet potato, roots store food inside them. Thus, roots swell and take different shapes. We call them storage roots. Banyan tree is very huge in size and it has normal taproot system. But in the picture, you can see that this tree produces massive branches. So to support these branches, additional roots called prop roots are produced by plant. Now have a look at the pictures of maize, sugarcane, jowar plants. These are monocotyledonous plants and they have fibrous roots. But fibrous roots are not enough to support the stem. Hence, their stems produce stilt roots for extra support. Students, whenever you visit Konkan or any other region along the seashore, observe plants called mangroves. These plants grow near the seashore in salty water of sea. They produce breathing roots or pneumatophores to take up oxygen. Note that breathing roots grow away from soil. Summary. Today you have studied structure and types of root system from plants. Apart from normal functions of roots, some roots are produced for special purpose. These are called root modifications. Challenge for your students. Observe roots of tomato, chilies, sugarcane, bean. Identify their root systems and based on root system, classify these plants into monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Imagine, what will happen if plants start moving like animals? Also decide to grow one plant in a pot on your birthday. Purchase it on your birthday. Keep it in the balcony of your room or keep it in your school. Water it regularly and study its growth. In this way, all the students can develop a garden in the school.